Hello everyone, welcome to this session of class 9 mathematics, and I am your Anu for MathSchool.1. Last classes we have been seeing factorization techniques, how to factorize algebraic expressions, and in this class too we'll continue with the factorization of algebraic expressions using identities. Okay, so let's get started right away. Now today we are going to see about factorization. Actually last class we have been seeing splitting the middle terms and difference of two squares, isn't it? So this class it is like factorization of algebraic expression expressible as sum of difference of two cubes. Okay, so sum of difference of two cubes, sum and sum as well as sum or difference of two cubes. So let me first tell you what is sum of cubes and difference of cubes. So when we write a cube plus b cube, I have already given you the list of identities. So when we write a cube plus b cube, we write it as a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. I told you to take the sign where if it is plus here, put plus here and take the opposite sign inside the second term. Okay, then a cube minus b cube, that is the difference of cubes, is a minus b into a square plus ab plus b square, isn't it? So that is how we move with a cube plus b cube and a cube minus b cube. Now the given question is x plus 1 the whole cube plus x minus 1 the whole cube. So this is sum of cubes. So sum of cubes, it is readily available. So x plus 1 plus x minus 1. So this is a plus b now. A plus b I have written here into a square. What is a square? X plus 1 the whole square. Okay, x plus 1 the whole square minus a into b. That is x plus 1 into x minus 1 plus b square. X minus 1 the whole square. Okay, do you understand? We are just writing the identities formula. So x plus 1 plus x minus 1, you have 1 cancelled here. So 2x into inside x squared plus 2x plus 1. See, x plus a plus b the whole square, it is a square plus 2ab plus b square minus x squared minus 1 square. This is a plus b into a minus b, so a squared minus b square plus x squared minus 2x plus 1. Okay, see, just simplify this. X squared plus 2x plus 1 minus x squared plus 1 plus x squared minus 2x plus 1. So whichever I can cancel it out. 2x 2x, so the remaining is x squared plus 2. So 2x into x squared, see x squared left out, 1 plus 1 plus 1, that is 3 here. Okay, so x squared plus 3, you have 2x here, so this becomes 2x into x squared plus 3. See, you have the term 2x into x squared plus 3, so these two terms are in product, so either 2x is a factor or x cubed plus 3 is a factor for us, or you can also write it like this, 2x cube plus 6x. It can also be written like this, but anyway you have to further, if you further simplify it, it will come like this, 2x into x cube plus 3, they are in product, so you can take this as h. So 2x and x squared plus 3 are factors of the above expression. Okay, now the next sum is x cube plus 3x squared plus 3x minus 7. Okay, it is given here x cube plus 3x squared plus 3x minus 7. You are given with. Now we need, actually I told you this is of the type sum or difference of cubes, isn't it? Now we have a full expression here. Now we need to change this expression to sum or difference of cubes, because we have a cube here. So we'll try to make it that way. So how to make it? Actually, x cube plus 3x squared plus 3x plus some coefficient we have, but all the way going around, all the way to factorize, finding out the factors and finding out the what are the factors of 7, we need to find them, and we need to move into trial and error method, the earlier method we did in the beginning, isn't it? So that will be a very tedious process. Instead of that, let me do it this way. 3x squared plus 3x. Okay, let me have it like this. And see, for minus 1, what I write is, I write minus 8 plus 1. I take this as minus 8 plus 1. So why do I take it like this? Because minus 8 plus 1 is 7 here. Now you see 3x cube plus 3x squared plus 3x plus 1. I split it like this, plus 1 and minus 8. I take the term together, this term together, and 2 and 8 separately, because minus 8 is minus 2 cube for me. So I have a cube term, I got a cube term there. And minus is there. So when if I can change this to cube, then it will be the difference of two cubes, so that I can apply the identity here. Now x cube plus 3x cube plus 3x plus 1. Now this resembles, see, I take x cube, that is a cube plus b cube plus 3 a squared b plus 3 a b squared. Okay, so let you take this term, that is a cube plus b cube plus 3 a squared b plus 3 a b squared, which is nothing but a plus b the whole cube, isn't it? So this is the formula, this is the identity. So this actually, the term represents, resembles this x cube plus 3x squared plus 3x plus 1 resembles this here. How? It means a cube is just like x cube, and b cube is here 1 cube. This 1 can be written as 1 cube. Now 3a squared b, that is a square, you have x squared, and b is 1 here, and 3ab squared, a is x for you and b squared is 1 squared, that is 1. So this resembles the identity here. So I just write 3x squared into 1 plus 3 1 into a square b square plus 1 cube minus 2. You understand? So now this becomes a plus b the whole cube identity. I can follow this. So I write x plus 1 the whole cube here minus 2. You understand? So I make this expression minus 7, I split it into minus 8 and plus 1. I have plus 1 here along with the expression, and minus 8 separate, so that it becomes minus 2 cube. So now this is difference of cubes, isn't it? Now I apply difference of cubes, that is a minus b, a cube minus b cube is a minus b into a squared plus ab, that is 2 into x plus 1 plus b squared. Okay, do you understand? A cube minus b cube is a minus b into a squared plus ab plus b squared. So this becomes x plus 1 minus 2 is x minus 1 into, I expand this, x squared plus 1 plus 2x, a plus b the whole square plus 2x plus 2 plus 4. Okay, now this becomes x minus 1 into, see, x squared 2x plus 2x 4x, 1 plus 2 6, that is 7. So I have x minus 1, x squared plus 4x plus 7. Do you understand? So that is how we obtain the factors. This is a term and this is a term. Those are in products. So these two are factors for the given expression, that is x cube plus 3x squared plus 3x minus 7. Okay. So even if an expression is given, we need to find out how we can change it into cubes or squares respectively to apply the identity, suitable identity to it. Now the third one we have is 0.87 into 0.87 into 0.87 plus 0.13 into 0.13 into 0.13. See, these kind of sums, we need to apply the identity directly because we have it directly. 0.87 into 0.13 plus 0.13 into 0.13. Okay, you understand? So this needs to be 1. You need to prove the left hand side is equal to 1 now. Now, if you observe, see, you have 3 terms in product and 3 terms in product. I write this simply as 0.87 the whole cube plus 0.13 the whole cube divided by 0.87 the whole square minus 0.87 into 0.13 plus 0.13 the whole square. See, if you observe this is a cube plus b cube, and here you have a square minus ab plus b square, isn't it? So what is a cube plus b cube here? What is a cube plus b cube? We know a cube plus b cube is equal to a plus b into a square minus ab into b square, isn't it? So I have applied the identity directly. This resembles a cube plus b cube. So I have expanded it to a plus b into a square minus ab plus b square. Sorry, this is plus b square. Now in the denominator we have the same term, a square minus ab plus b square. See, I have taken a as 0.87 and b as 0.13. So you have the same term. You can cancel both, isn't it? Now 0.87 plus 0.13, 10. See, exactly it comes to 1, and hence proved. Do you understand? Just you need to observe what identity it follows, and then you need to apply the identity to get the answer. Do you understand? That is how we simplify and we factorize. Our aim is to represent the given expression in products. Say these are in terms, separate terms. It's called an algebraic expression. We need to make them into factors. We need to represent them as product of terms. Product of terms are nothing but factors, isn't it? Factors are given in the form of product of terms. So with that we can simplify it easily. Now the next one with the same type is 2a plus 5b into 4a square minus 10ab plus 25b squared. So this also follows the same identity. See, 2a plus 5b, and if you observe, you have 2a the whole square, that is 4a square, and here for 25b squared is 5b the whole square. 5b and 2a together, 2a into 5b together will give you 10ab, isn't it? So now we observe, this is a, this is b, this is a square minus ab plus b square, isn't it? So this follows the identity, and this will give you a cube plus b cube. This sign we need to carry here. So a cube plus b cube. So directly we can write 2a the whole cube plus 5b the whole cube. That is 8a cube 125 v cube. So that will be your answer. You understand? So you just need to observe, see how the algebraic expressions, if it follows a pattern, if it resembles an identity, you just substitute the values in that identity. Okay. So if you have a thorough knowledge of identities, factorization will be more simpler. Along with the techniques, you need to know what kind of technique we have to use to factorize. Okay. So this type is regarding sum or difference of cubes. Our next type is factorization by using the formula for cube of a polynomial. So we just need to use the formula for finding the cube of the polynomial. By that way, we can factorize a given expression. So first one is 64a cube minus 27b cube minus 144a squared b plus 108ab square. So whenever you have terms like this, see whether it is cube or square, you just see what are the terms involved in it, whether you can see those terms in any of the identity. See, if we see this, we see a cube minus b cube minus 3a squared b plus 3ab squared, and this is nothing but a minus b the whole cube, isn't it? See, I have all the terms here which are given here. See, a cube term is there, b cube is there, and a squared b term is there, and ab squared is there. So you just substitute a minus b the whole cube in it. But do you have really a cube and b cube? So that we need to check. So for 64, I can write it as 4a the whole cube. For 27, I can write it as 3b the whole cube, because 3 cube is 27. Minus 3 I take separately. See, 4 and 3. I need to get 144 here, isn't it? So 144a squared, that is 3 into a squared into b. Now what is a squared here? A squared is 4a the whole squared into b. Not just the 4a squared, this is 4a the whole squared. So you will be having 16 here. So 16 into 9, that is what 144 is here. Okay, so plus 3a squared, 3ab squared. A is just a, so 4a. And what is b squared here? 3b the whole squared. Okay, so we need to check. Just, we are checking whether the coefficient resembles. Actually, 3 into 16, this is because 4a the whole squared, because 3, so 3 into 16 into 8. I mean 3, that is 3 3's are 9, 9 into 16 is 144. Next, 3 into 4 is 12, 12 into 9, because 3 the whole squared, so 9, so 12 into 9, that is 108. So the coefficients matches, so this is 4a minus 3b the whole cube, because only if you have minus here, you have the cube term minus, and wherever you have b, you have minus term. Okay, so this is what we have. 4a minus 3b the whole cube. That is 4a minus 3b is a factor of the above expression. Do you understand? So that is how you just correlate, see whether the coefficients and the given variables are similar to any other identity we have. Okay. So the next one is x plus y the whole cube minus x minus y the whole cube minus 6y into x square minus y square. Okay, so this is what we have, 6y into x, 6y into x square minus y square. Now you are given with x plus y the whole cube, x minus y the whole cube minus 6y into x square minus y square. Okay, so how do we expand this, or how do we take it out? So let us see. I have x plus y and x minus y here. Let me do it, let me make it more clear for you. X minus y the whole cube, 6y into, let me have this as x plus y into x minus y. See, I have x plus y and x minus y here. So let me take x as, let me take a to b. So I don't take the same thing, same x as this, but I take a as x plus y and b as x minus y. Now you see a cube minus b cube minus 6 into x squared minus, now this can be written as x plus y into x minus y. But what about 6y here? Isn't it? We have 6y here, that can't be written as a or b or something like that. Yes, we can write it as a or b. See, x plus y minus x minus y. What do you have? X plus y minus x plus y, so xx gets cancelled, you have 2y, isn't it? X plus y minus x minus y is 2y here, so I can write this 6y as 3 into 2y, 3 into 2y, and what is 2y here? 2y is nothing but x plus y minus x minus y, isn't it? Do you understand what I am saying? 2y is x plus y and minus x minus y. We have taken x plus y as a and x minus y as b. So I write, instead of y, I write a minus b. Do you understand? See, when I subtract x plus y and x minus y, I get 2y. I split this 6y as 3 into 2y. And for 2y, I have, 2 will not be here. Because since 2y is equal to, this x plus y I have taken as a and x minus y I have taken as b. So this becomes a minus b. So 3 into a minus b I have written. For 6y I have written 3 into a minus b. Now what about x plus y and x minus y? It becomes a b. 3 into a minus b into a b. See, this becomes a cube minus b cube. Minus 3ab into a minus b. I have told you, I have given you identities. So one way of writing a minus b the whole cube is a cube minus b cube minus 3a squared b plus 3ab squared, isn't it? Or else we can write it like this also, minus 3ab into a plus b, because when I expand this I get minus 3a squared b plus 3ab squared. So this is nothing but a minus b the whole cube. You understand how do we arrive at the a minus b the whole cube? Just substitute a is equal to x plus y and b is equal to x minus y. Subtract both these, you will get 2y. Put 2y in 6y's place, you substitute 2y a minus b and this is ab. Okay, so you get a minus b the whole cube. I'm substituting a minus b the whole cube here. What is a? A minus b the whole cube is equal to x plus y minus x minus y the whole cube. So x plus y minus x plus y the whole cube, that is xx gets cancelled, you get 2y the whole cube, that is 8y cube. Now do you understand how do we simplify the given terms? Isn't it? By using the formula of cubes we simplify the given algebraic expression. Okay, so we have 8y cube as the answer. So that is how we use algebraic identities for factorization as well as simplifying given terms. So these are some types of factorizations and simplifications. We still have two other forms of factorization. We have still have cubic identities, cubic identities, still more two types of cubic identities to be solved. We'll see it in the next class. And until then, it's bye from Anu. Keep practicing. Have fun. For maxschool.1. Thank you.